Let's see what it says about Summit. Because we've got Summit going on. Summit going on. It says, hop history, got bitter. This is one of the I alpha acid hops on the market and becoming more and more popular. Then it's got all aromas and things like that and what flavour profile. Good little book. Get yourself one of these. Hop varieties, isn't it? While I'm on about things like this, Brewers and marketing divisions and God knows what else you got. Listen up and behave yourself. Sit up straight, cross your arms and fold your legs, everything else. We want to see a little kind of hot, like little description, instead of telling us what to taste, which I think, according to some people, you've got the supermarkets kind of demand it a little bit. But have it all sectioned out in taste notes, big sort of thing above it, then little writing. And then ingredients, hops, malts, water, yeast, all that business. Kind of smart us up a little bit. Because then we'll go, oh, I really enjoyed that one with Summit in it, or with that one with Amarillo and Citra and God knows what else, and Fuggles and, you know. And I really enjoyed that one. God, that was lovely. And Challenger and Goldings and all that. Oh, lovely. And you'll kind of get to know the hops that you really like. Oh, no, I'll steer clear of Citra. I don't like all that fruity. It's too bit of that sort of stuff, you know. Or you will go towards it, you know. I've gone off right off the remit. You know. Start the clock, Till. I've already gone about 5 minutes in and I'm still talking. What was I on about? Oh yeah, let's have a little ingredient list. You know, it'd be nice to have a full ingredient list anyway, but it'd be really nice, rather than, you know, I know I moan about it, but I'm not overly worried about a little bit of colouring or a little bit of this, when it's done in a way that some of the big firms, they need to kind of keep the beers dead matching, dead in colour and everything else. I still think it's cheating. And the same way that when you go buy whiskies and that, they throw colour into galore, because otherwise anything less than, a three-year-old whiskey is going to look insipid. It's going to look watery. And it'll almost be watercoloured, almost. So they chuck loads of colouring in these things, and you know, and it looks like some breweries are going the same way. This one ain't. So we're going to try a proper beer, and this is Summit. And let's hope it's something special. You're not good, you know. Nothing like blowing your own trumpet, is it? Let's put the thing on the neck there. I say, he who blows his own trumpet has got an orchestra of one. I think it depends how you blow it. Get on with it, Till. Let's crash it open. Here we go. Put it on there. Put the ring back on. Why does it have a sniff in your neck? That ain't your bowl. Because you get interesting little aromas coming up when they've just been released. Sometimes very volatile things, they'll disappear so quickly that you will only get hints later on of them. Whereas on straight away on the neck, you'll go, gotcha. And then it'll lead you a bit by the kind of by the nose almost at the drinks later. Right. Over there. Nice kind of, as I said, fluffy northern head. Nice fluffy head on it, it's quite pretty. Colour chameleon. There we go. And that is a nice goldy colour there. That's lovely. Goldy sort of straw like. Let's have a little swirly swirl, because once the head's been there for more than a few seconds, you won't smell nothing for it. Because the aroma, like, smells and that dissipate really quick, just leaving them stretchy, big old wheaty sort of molecules and that. Probably is a bit of wheat in there just to help that along. Probably a bit of torrified wheat or something like that. Right, so let's give it a twirly smell. Deep, 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 deep. Kind of do a little wave, like that. You can't see certain glasses, you can't do that in there. It'll go. But gathered glasses, these are the best ones, what they call shakers. Drink everything from these. You know, there's people who say, no, you need this sort of shape, and a quack glass needs to be like this, and oh dear. There's tiny, tiny, tiny bits of difference in drinking out of different glasses. But if you're drinking a good beer, if you're drinking it out of Yvonne Goolagong's trainers, you know, or, you know, it'll still taste like a good beer, hopefully. If you're drinking a McLager, you can drink it out of the best glass ever. You can drink it out of a champagne glass. Ain't going to be champagne, is it? Right, so, you know, nice shaker glass, good stuff. Twirly twirl, stick your bugle in. Stop twirling and talking to people. Very pleasant. Very pleasant and lovely. It's made me smile already, that is. Yeah, I like that. Straight away I'm smiling. Getting nice little aromas and things out of that. Oh, wet me nose. Again, this big quilt, it's a bit, I don't know. People love to see that fluff. I don't like. It gets in the way for me. Let's stick a bit of bonch juice on it. That'll bring it down a little bit. Right, you've seen it now. If I put a bit of salt and grease on there, that'll kill that, destroy it quickly. Right, and then I'll get to the surface area. So it needs a little bit of that, and that will die down really quickly now. Sorry, but there you go. You know, you've seen enough. Right, there we go. Now the kind of salt off my skin's killed it, without altering the flavours on there. Right. Now I can start telling you about it. Nice little kind of wheaty notes in there. Nice little gentle. Really nice gentle notes, little gentle bit in this, there's little morel mushroom earthy notes. Nice little kind of fruity edges, little zesty edges, little citrus edges on him. Really nice little tangerines, little fistless little things. There's a little leaves, crispy leaf things. Would you believe you kind of get... You're not going to like it. You're going to go, what? But if you get freshly picked, I mean, the tomato is a fruit. And when you get it freshly picked, it tastes like a fruit. And it's sweet and still a little bit sharp at the same time. When you get them out of the shop and the way the sugars in them for a start turn into starches, the acids in them die off. So you end up with a bland tomato. But this has got those little lovely tomato sort of edges when it's fruity. It's like a fruity tomato. Slight little notes of that in there. That's really nice. Right, let's go in. Cheers. Bottoms up, chin chin. Oh, I like that. Oh, I like that. That's one of them. And again, one of those beers that, you know, if you're a McLager drinker and that, and you want to get away from lagers and you get away from the Indoctrination Corporation Popsy McLagers, Popsy McLagers, and you want to get away from those, another gateway beer. This one just will lead you down a path. It's not difficult drinking, but it makes me go a little bit kind of red almost. all the blood suddenly goes through. See, if I'm tasting a beer, I'm like, ooh, like that. Or if I'm playing chess and I'm thinking hard, I'll go a bit red and a bit tingy sometimes, and all that. It's where all the blood suddenly goes, ooh, the head needs me, the head needs me. See round here, look. It's a weird thing. Can't play poker or nothing like that, because the minute I get a good hand, everyone goes, fold. Right, let's have a taste. Can't lie or anything like that. Oh, I like that. I really like that. That is a lovely beer. Right, describe it instead of just saying I really like that. Nice little biscuity notes. Nice, very strange sort of biscuit. There's a bitterness that's going along. It's kind of like, picture this. Right, picture getting a kind of, oh, let's see if I can get this right. Right, you've got to really picture this. Picture getting a kind of one of them Ritz cracker round biscuit things. The Ritz, is it Ritz crackers? Isn't it Ritz ones? Round biscuits, scraping all the cheesy stuff. So you're just down to white stuff, shaving all the toppy cheesy stuff. So just down to the white finish. Right, and then dipping that into a grapefruit. Yeah, you've got something like it then. Then you've got little nuts and kind of little hints of honey in there as well. That's nice. I like that. I really like that. Glorious stuff. That's gone, by the way. it ain't all gone because I got more. Now I'm going to pour the second bit in. And it may come out cloudy. To me, I don't give a summit. And it, as it happens, not come out cloudy at all. Right, bottoms up, chin chin. See you in the next one. Don't be late because I'll start without you and I'm going to enjoy that. See you soon. Take care. Biddly biddly boo. See you in the next one. With a man to the world, with a man.